أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم وميثاقه الذي واثقكم به إذ قلتم سمعنا وأطعنا واتقوا الله إن الله عليم بذات الصدور. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين لله شهداء بالقسط ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. وعد الله الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم. والذين كفروا وكذبوا بآياتنا أولئك أصحاب الجحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ هم قوم أن يبسطوا إليكم أيديهم فكف أيديهم عنكم واتقوا الله وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. سورة المائدة آية نمبر 7. الله سبحانه وتعالى says here: واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم وميثاقه الذي واثقكم به. And remember the favor of Allah upon you and his covenant with which he bound you when you said, we hear and we obey. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the believers to remember his favor. Why? Because when you remember the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will thank him. Why people, many people don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because they will forget the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gave you a lot of things, your hands, your legs, the air you can breathe, many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. So when you forget, you don't worship Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنِسِيَهُمْ about the kuffar. They forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means they left worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left them in the hellfire. And Allah did not protect them. So this is the main thing in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you'll find many times in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us his favors. How many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in Surah Al-Nahl. It is called Surah Al-Ni'am. Surah Al-Nahl. What's the meaning of Nahl? Bees. Bees. Another name? Surah Al-Ni'am. Huh? The blessings, yes. It is Surah Al-Ni'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many things for the Allah gave to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Try to count how many ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, you cannot count that. But subhanAllah, the shaitan makes us to focus on what we are missing. I don't have a nice car. I don't have a big house. You have a small house. I don't have a big house. The shaitan turns your face toward the one who has a palace, not toward the your face toward the one who's homeless. And the famous story of Urwa ibn Zubair, rahimahullah, when he had a disease in one of his limbs, his arm. They mentioned it has gangrene. So they said, we should cut your hand, amputation. So after that, when he woke up from that surgery, they told him, يعني احتسب. احتسب. What does it mean for احتسب? يعني with the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My arm? They said, no, your son, one of your sons. He said, oh, Allahumma laka alhamd. Oh Allah, all the grace to, due to you, all praise to you. You gave me four limbs, you took one and you three left for me. Yani he's thinking what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept for him more than what he took. Oh Allah, you gave me four or seven children, you took one of them and the others are okay. So of course this is a very strong level of faith that you thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the calamities. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And remember the favor of Allah upon you. And the main favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us is Al-Islam. Al-Islam. Al-Islam that we Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us to Islam, this is the greatest favor. Al-Islam, Al-Qur'an, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم وميثاقه الذي واثقكم به and his covenant with which he bound you when you said we hear and we obey وميثاقه الذي واثقكم به وقلتم سمعنا وأطعنا. So we should remember the ميثاق. What is the ميثاق here? الإسلام. When the Muslims came to the, when the companions came to the Prophet ﷺ, gave him the bay'ah. What is the bay'ah? Hadith Ubad ibn Samit radiallahu ta'ala an said, bay'ana, okay, we gave the pledge. The Prophet ﷺ, ala al-sam'i wa ta'ah. Ala al-sam'i wa ta'ah. This is the same in the Quran. Qultum sami'na wa ata'na. The same thing. We hear and we obey. Then he said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, fi man shatina wa makrahina wa usrina wa yusrina wa atharatin alayna. Maybe when you hear the word sam'i wa ta'ah, maybe it is easy. Okay. I hear what is mentioned in the Quran, I obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here, emphasizing that you should do while any case. You are strong, you are weak, you are, you like, you don't like. This is the test. When you obey, even if you don't like, you are not convinced. This is the test. He said, في منشطنا ومكرهنا. What's منشطنا? منشطنا from نشاط, active. Okay, when you, I tell you something that you like, so you do that, very happy. You tell your son, go to the جمعية, go to the supermarket, bring some detergent to clean, wash. You find him maybe lazy, but you tell him, go to bring some chocolate. 1 minute, صح? So the Muslim should listen, obey the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he is manshatina, he is active, he is happy in doing that. وَهِي مَكْرَهِنَا And the things that he dislikes. This is the Muslim, it is mentioned in the Quran, you do. وَعُسْرِنَا وَيُسْرِنَا What's mean usr? When there is like this lack of money, it is difficulty. There is a difficulty. You come and you do the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you are, I have shop. If I close my shop and I go to the masjid, I walk to the masjid 5 minutes. Then 5 minutes making wudu. Then 5 minutes waiting the salah or doing the sunnah. Then 10 minutes. So I will waste 30 minutes. So how many customers I'm going to lose? The shaitan comes to you. Subhanallah. يعني, you know, some people, or maybe a few people. Where do they live? Mecca. You ask them, how many hajj? Zero. Wallah, when I hear this, strange. يعني, maybe I was thinking, he will tell me maybe 20, 30. Zero. Why? Because this is the type of business. He's ready to close his shop the whole year, 11 months. But for Dhul Hijjah, impossible. Okay, but Hajj, it is in Dhul Hijjah. Subhanallah. So, usrina wa yusrina, when it is very difficult, and wa yusrina, when it, we are at ease. طيب. Then he said, wa atharatin alayna. What's mean atharatin alayna? Even that you listen and obey to your Amir, your leader, even he has athara. What's mean athara? He is oppressing in, or he is oppressor in distributing the wealth. He should distribute, for example, the same. For example, 10 KD. No. You will take 5 KD from this side, 15 KD. 10 KD, 5 KD. So this is called athara. I'm taking the right of someone, giving to someone else. Why? This is Kuwaiti. And this is not Kuwaiti. Or this is my brother. This is from my from the same tribe. Okay, from the same skin color. And this is unknown. Or not from the same nationality. This is athara. Okay, I'm giving because of my relationship, wasta, whatever, haram. This is haram. This is haram. So what should I do? I go and I fight and I say I don't obey. No, you should listen and obey, of course, if it is not haram. Even if your leader is doing wrong, haram things. And this hadith of Bukhari Muslim. Then he said, he said, Ubad ibn Samit, وَأَلَّا نُنَازِعَ الْأَمْرَ أَهْلَهُ. And we should not fight this issue, his people, which means we should not fight the leaders. Which means the Muslim leaders. إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِلَّا, except there is an exception, that you are allowed to fight this leader. You should fight, or you are allowed to fight him. I take my sword, my army to fight him. When? إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا كُفْرًا بَوَاحًا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ بُرْهَانًا. When you see, إِلَّا أَن تَرَوْا, see. The scholars say means, this means when you are sure. Not wallahi, someone told me. Okay, it is written in the media. No, the issue here, because it is very serious, you should see, you are 100% sure, 1000% sure. Like the zina, that adultery. Okay, when we do the punishment, because this is something very serious, sensitive issue, so we need 4 witnesses. For the zina, for adultery, how many witnesses? Usually, how many witnesses? 2. But here, when you come to zina, because it is very serious, so you need 4 witnesses, because it is not easy. The sin is not easy, and also the punishment not easy. So the same thing here. Because this issue is a serious issue, so until you, number one, illa an taro, you see. Number 2, kufran, a disbelief. Then he said, bawahan, very clear, not different opinions. Because you know some issues, you find scholars saying this is kufr, other scholars saying not kufr. You find this is the fiqh issues. In the fiqh issues, is he kafir or not kafir? So if there is an issue, different opinions, so you are not allowed to follow your opinion, nor he is kafir, we should fight him. Maybe yes, what he's doing is major mistake, but it is not agreed upon, and it is not clear by the proofs from the Quran, Sunnah. We can understand it the other way, the scholars. So it should be clear kufr. طيب. عندكم من الله فيه برهان. And there is a proof. From where the proof? He said, من الله. The proof from Allah. What does it mean of that? You have the proof from the Quran and Sunnah that this act or this saying is a disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. So in Islam, we have this concept that to fight the leader, the ruler. But there are conditions for that. there are conditions for that. And also, we should add al-qudra, that you can fight this leader. We don't want to go to fight, and we are very weak. Now imagine, we proved all of these things. The ruler, he did something. Kufa, he saw him doing a disbelief. And this is a jima' that this disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the scholars agree that he is kafir. But we are weak. We don't have guns. We don't have tanks. We don't have power. So for sure, if we go to fight him, he will put all of us in jail. So don't fight. You should wait. You should wait. Another hadith also, Ubadah ibn Samit radiyallahu ta'ala an, he said, and Ubadah ibn Samit, ahad al-nuqaba laylat al-aqaba. What does it mean, ahad al-nuqaba? Before the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Medina, there were meetings, not only one meeting. What was the time of meeting? Hajj time. Where? In Mina. He did a meeting with a few of the Ansar. And what was the next appointment? Next year. So subhanAllah, you need da'wah, you need the patience. You find sometimes people, they want everything quickly. And you need some patience. Why? Because you are building a country. You are not building a blocks, playing with your kids. Okay, even building the doing the blocks, you know the blocks? Or the, what they call the small ones. The Legos, yeah. Okay? Also, you need to focus. You need time. You need to follow the manual. So building country is not something easy. You need time, the Prophet ﷺ. So, yeah, he met the companion, the Ansar. The members, they are called Nuqaba. The members called Nuqaba. So one of them, Ubadah ibn Samit, he said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, bayi'u, the Prophet ﷺ told them, because he wants to make sure, before coming to you, I need to make sure you are ready to support the da'wah, to protect me. Like protecting your women and your children. You need this for the da'wah. What do you notice? The Prophet ﷺ did not say, yalla, you agree, I'm coming. The Prophet ﷺ took the means how to follow the steps firmly. I want to make sure that you are ready. Not, the issue is not you become Muslim, yalla, let's start another country. The issue is not like this. He said, bay'uni, give me the bay'ah. Don't do shirk. Don't steal. لا تسرقوا. Don't commit zina. ولا تزنوا. Don't kill your children. ولا تأتوا ببهتان. بهتان is the one of the worst lie. بهتان. تفترونه بين أيديكم وأرجلكم. Between your legs and your arms. ولا تأسوا في معروف. Don't disobey with me, fi ma'ruf, when I'm telling you something good, something not haram. And if you notice in Islam, emphasizing the concept of what? Obedience. This is very important to obey. And we don't want in Islam everyone has an idea. Yeah, no, I want to do my idea. I don't agree with your opinion. Allah ma'a salam. I start in another group. No, you should be patient with your friends. Why? The concept of jama'ah. The concept of the jama'ah, and I think I did khutbah maybe last month about the jama'ah. Okay? Very important, the concept of congregation. Of course, if it is not haram, because sometimes you find people, subhanAllah, ridiculous. Because he doesn't like the food. Okay, we order food, for example, chicken. I don't like chicken, khalas. He will take 2-3 people, let's have pizza. SubhanAllah, you break the jama'ah because of food. We are not doing something haram. Haram to order biryani? No, not haram. But because he doesn't like. You notice some people nowadays like this. He doesn't like this place, this food. well, I don't like this person. حبيبي, the da'wah is something bigger than the personal issues. طيب, so he said, ولا تعصوا في معروف, don't disobey in the good things. Then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, فمن وفى منكم فأجره على الله. The one who fulfills his reward, 1 million dinar, his reward, على الله, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is also a very important point. And da'wah, you know, nowadays, many times we hear that, يعني, no, we need money for the da'wah, and we should give money for the da'i, we give money for the those who are working. It is not mandatory. Look, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his da'wah, built on the for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who have money, they contributed. Abu Bakr brought his money. All of his money, صح? In one of the incidents. Umar, how much? Half. Abdul Rahman ibn Uthman ibn Affan, he prepared the army in Ghazwa Tabuk. He bought the well of Ruma. I mean, sometimes you hear people saying, there is no money, no da'wah. It's wrong. Smiling, Hajji. Why smiling? Out of Shinu, there is secret between. What is the password? This is the point. The trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah, I feel sorry when there is no money, no da'wah. This is wrong. From what he started, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also don't teach your people, okay, that everything, there should be a return. I do filming, there should be something. I go to that place, should be something. Not always this. Of course, it doesn't mean that what people doing, like the Islamic centers, it is haram to make the salary for the employees. I don't mean that. But I'm talking about this concept, wrong concept. No money, no da'wah, this is wrong. Look what the Prophet ﷺ said. You give me a pledge, no shirk, don't steal this. Then the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fi sabilillah. Okay? The reward, he said, فَمَنْ وَفَى مِنْكُمْ فَأَجْرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. But when the booty came, he distributed for the mujahideen. When people giving zakah, the Prophet ﷺ helping the needy. Tamam? So yeah, also this is good for, this is an important point for also the da'wah field. If you have good resources, you should support also your people. I should not leave someone who's, mashallah, very active in da'wah, but he's struggling. Right? Yeah, for example, his salary is 200 KD and he has family, wife and 3 children. Okay, and I want him to be in da'wah 5 hours a day. I say 5 hours a day, then I'm telling him do this fi sabilillah. Okay, but he needs to find another job. So I can't tell him, ta'al, I'll give you how much you are taking for a second job. 150, khalas, this 150, but stay in da'wah. So it should be both sides. The da'i, those who are working da'wah, they should intend fi sabilillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who are in charge should appreciate that. Both sides. Come on. I don't mean to give me something. Yeah. Come on. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَنْ أَصَابَ مِنْ ذَلِكَ شَيْئًا. And anyone commits anything, which means any sin, فَعُوقِبَ فِي الدُّنْيَا, he was punished in dunya, then it is his expiation. You did something, you did the zina, may Allah protect us, and he is single, not married, he did the adultery, what is the punishment? 100 lashes. وَتَغْرِيبَ عَامٍ, and also to kick him out of the country 1 year. Okay, and there are rules about that. Is it the jail? Is it a replacement for that rule? So this is his kafara. So if he took his punishment in dunya, Allah will not punish him in the akhirah. Then, and the one who did one of these things, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covered him. Then his issue for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wills, punishes him, and if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, forgives him. This hadith, then Ubay ibn Samit, فَبَايَعْنَا, we gave him the pledge. This hadith Bukhari, Muslim. Then at the end of the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. If you notice here, yeah, subhanAllah, this is the third time. Yani, this is which ayah? Number 7. This is the third time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. And if you notice the next ayah, ayah number 8, اعْدِلُهُ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fourth time. Also, if you go to ayah number 11, فَكَفَ أَيْدِيَهُمْ عَنْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Five times. So subhanAllah, Allah is repeating what? The issue of taqwa, 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 taqwa. Even ayah five times. If you check these 11 ayah, you'll find five times. What is the point of that? The importance of taqwa Allah. If there is taqwa Allah, Allah, you'll find the Muslim community straight. Taqwa Allah. Maybe you hear that now in the government. How many times? Punching. Three times. Three times. US in between. In. What is the punching? In and out. In and out. Now, the third one, checking. Why? Because there is no taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All people, and this is wrong. If there is taqwa Allah, no need for in, out, checking, no need. Okay? But also, this the third punching doesn't control all people because you find people leaving. Okay, in some places, okay, my sister, she's working in a clinic. He said, 9 o'clock, leave. Yalla, ma'a salam. Why? Taqwallah. Taqwallah. And if you remember when you spoke about the Surah Al-Baqarah, the husband-wife relationship, you'll find what? Taqwallah in these ayat. Because this is a very important issue. Because they need to go to the court. Okay, I think I mentioned this point. You'll find the wife is struggling, and she has the right to ask for divorce. Basically, asking divorce is haram without a reason. But if she has a reason, she has the right. For example, he's beating, he doesn't give money. She has the right. Okay, how to get the divorce? She doesn't have the authority to divorce herself, صح? It is in the hand of the man. But she has the way through the court. The man knows that, and the court will not give the divorce within 1 day, or 2 days, or 1 month, 2 months. Okay, at least 6 months, at least. In Kuwait, if you want the woman wants a divorce, she needs 6 months. Right? So you'll find the husband, the bad husband, pushing his wife to do what? Khulba. Why? Because he's a bad man. He doesn't have taqwa Allah. Okay? I will not do the talaq. You should do talaq. Because you are not giving the wife her rights. Right? No, I will not do talaq. Because also another thing, if he does talaq, okay, people will speak, you divorce your wife. So he wants to protect his dignity and his ego. I am a good man. But when people hear khul, it means not from me, from my wife. Okay, so these kinds of problems, okay, how to control that? Taqwa Allah, not the rules, not the court. Taqwa Allah. That's why you find taqwa Allah in the ayat of talaq, of divorce. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Then he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah is knowing of that within the chest. Here, what is the translation? Allah is knowing. Knowing from the word, العلم. But what is mentioned here in the Quran? خبير. Actually, the word خبير, yes, it is from knowledge, from علم. But it is about what? Yes. بواطن الأمور. We have the names, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, العليم. The name of Allah, الخبير. The name of Allah, اللطيف. عليم, خبير, لطيف. All of them related to knowledge. So, العليم talk about the knowledge generally. وهو بكل شيء عليم, you'll find many آيات. But when you come to اللطيف, specifically about the small menu, the small things. اللطيف هو الذي يعلم دقائق الأمور. The small things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows exactly how many cells inside our body. Allah knows the viruses, Allah knows the component of everything, the positive, negative, the electrons, neutrons. Allah knows these things. Because subhanAllah, you find some people claim that Allah doesn't know the small things. Some philosophy people. And they are kuffar because of this belief. Al-Khabir means the one who knows the bawatin umur, the hidden. This is the beauty of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Eh? So, al-khabir about the hidden things, al-bawatin al-umur, al-latif, daqa'iq al-umur. Jazakumullah khair, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.